Let me be the first to welcome you all back to Brunswick, Maryland, as Amtrak PO 29, the westbound Captain Limited, is the first train of the day to greet us with yet again another COVID consist. With everything slowly coming back to life, the schedules for the freight train action have moved from night owl to daylight runs, as we observe the heart of the operation today on this cloudy, cool Sunday afternoon. And there she goes, westbound and down, as Amtrak 29 rides off into the invisible sunset, preparing to stop at Harper's Ferry. I was questioning myself with the whereabouts of CSX Q138 when I realized that they went on track 3 at Weaverton moving into Brunswick for reasons that I fully did not understand. Just like the airport, plans change when least unexpected. What threw me off completely was that Q138 had a medium clear to go from track 3 to 1 at North WB, which is the signal you see ahead. With the crew van chasing the head end to the signal, I knew that something was up. To my knowledge, this isn't a normal operation, especially here in Brunswick. Thank you. I turned around after the DPU pass and saw that Q-138 had double stacks on the rear, and now this makes sense. C6 Q-138 was dropping off the double stacks for C6 Q-136 to pick up later. The crew van met the conductor at the signal so that they could uncouple the double stacks and hook them up to an air unit that's at the signal so that the double stacks airline can be pressurized while waiting for C6 Q-136. The conductor then uncouples the double stack from the rest of the train and prepares the portable air hoses for usage while applying the handbrakes to the first car of the double stack. And with the process complete, CSX Q-138-16 proceeds eastbound to Baltimore's Penn Mary Yard, while the double stacks wait patiently for CSX Q-136-16 to pick them up later on. While waiting for other mainline trains, yard local CSX B712 pulls up and back a few times at North WB as they switch cars around at the yard, preparing for its outbound for Winchester, Virginia. They've been working for a few hours already and have till after nightfall to switch cars around and move out, with the road slug and two GP40-2s providing the power for tonight's CSX B712. As CSX B712 backs into the yard and disappears, CSX Q416 emerges at South WB as the dispatcher gives them permission to pull forward and reverse within the block so they can drop off one car into the yard. Q416 broke a knuckle around Clopper earlier and lost a few hours of operation time. Luckily, it's just one car into the yard today. Q416 has five locomotives leading, including three ES-44AHs, one ES-40DC, and a CW-40-9, which is a lucky catch for me, with a fresh coat of paint as they pull past South WB for reversing within the block.
Dispatcher checks those up.
Once Q416 gets the signal to reverse back into Brunswick, the conductor will relay the information back to the engineer that he will have a signal, in this case it will be a restricting, so that way they can proceed to reverse back into Brunswick to drop off that car the conductor is on, and then proceed back to couple up to the train that they just disconnected to proceed westbound towards Cumberland. A few moments later, CSX Q372 sneaks up on us on track 1 as they call out a clear at North WB and Maple Avenue as they head eastbound towards Philadelphia, Pennsylvania with a mighty consist tonight, with two GVOs leading and an SD70AC trailing third, which looks like one of CSX's new rebuild, as I was told that this unit was an ex-SD70M2. With the GVO mid-DPU sandwiched between the great consist, I say that this was the best train of the night, consist-wise, and power.
2372 17 East on 1. All clear. North WB. CSX 3241.
Thank you.
As CSX Q372 heads eastbound towards Philadelphia, Q416 is making its final move as they drop off that last grain car and are now reversing one last time to couple back up to the rest of Q416, which is just on the other side of South WB signal. You'll notice that Q416 doesn't have the signal, but is about to go through it. In this situation, it's okay, because the dispatcher gave him verbal permission to proceed through the signal at restricted speed, so they could couple up to the rest of the train. The reason why the dispatch can't get the signal is because the rest of the train is fouling the track just on the other side of the interlocking, and cannot give him at least a restricting signal, so it has to give him verbal permission to go through the red signal. Which, this is allowable in some cases, especially this one. As CSX Q416 creeps up to the rest of its consist, CSX Q136 sneaks up on us just like Q372 did earlier. CSX Q136 is slowing down because they're about to reverse at North WB to pick up the double stacks that Q138 dropped off earlier. With two GVOs at the power, not too bad for a train like this, especially since it'll be a little bit short. What I didn't realize is now that I'll be blocked between two of the railroad crossings going into the Canal Street area, as well as going back into town at Brunswick. I wouldn't get stuck behind two trains, but in this situation, you don't get to see much mainline switching, so I took this as a good opportunity, and for a good reason too.
So your video camera, I mean, like, you get pretty good low light performance from it?
Yeah, it gets pretty good. Nothing too fancy. This camera's 2012.
So is the conductor already in the back of the train? He got dropped off. Is the conductor back there?
No, he's still on the head end.
Oh, he okay.
What?
So he'll have to get back there.
Yes.
Okay.
So the train, that's why the train's going really slow here. So the conductor's going to get off here, walk to the back, and then we'll get on the end of the train. It's all right. That's the conductor, so he can't go to Weaverton because the crossing's too long, so he's just going to take him an 84 lumber. China shipping on it. MSC. Yeah. That's where you get the big cargo ship. Was it the Emma Maris? MSC is the second biggest. Grab that.
Once CSX Q136 cleared the crossing and the engine locking at North WB, the conductor climbed on the back and spotted the engineer to reverse back to the double stacks that were sitting on track 3. I relocated over to the double stacks to watch the procedure take place. Man, not one, not two, but three mainline trains switching right in front of me at Brunswick all in one day? Now I call that a good day. That was pretty long tonight.
Dispatch, Jacksonville, yeah. Q4, 1616, engine CSX T730.
They're getting that way. They want to save manpower.
Yeah.
Half car.
Fire your precision scheduled.
Yeah, stupid.
Yeah.
20 feet. Oh, a lot of good feet.
Dispatch, Q4, 1616.
I've heard all the stories. It's sad.
Okay, West, in this case, near Weaverton, we'll put you out one tracker.
I understand. Okay, come on.
While the conductor was hooking up the air hoses and setting up the EOT for Q136, C6 Q416 finally moves west towards Cumberland with the rest of their consists.
Alright, 377, I am in the clear of all tracks, releasing that 3. Okay to pull ahead. You said you had your counter set?
Seven to the head end, over.
Yeah, I got it set. You want me to pull a reel to you, just want you?
Yeah, I mean, unless you got a better idea.
I mean, if you can't get the van, go to the reel. Come back up.
Yeah, I could do that. Alright.
And just like that, CSX Q136 was on the move to East Brunswick to pick up their hard-working conductor after installing the EOT and a successful test of the brakes. And there she goes, heading eastbound to Portsmouth, Virginia, with their new addition. Throughout the years of train spotting, I don't think I've had this much action here since the retiring of Brunswick's B&O signals back in 2011, but this had to be the best day of spotting in Brunswick for the last 8 years. Well, that's all I have for now. Big thank you to Larry, C6Q136, and the new spotter that I just met that evening. Thank you all for watching. This is Train Productions, and we's out of here.